What's up, YouTube? Big Country 7914 here, back with another video for you. This one, NHL 21 game dropped yesterday. Unless you pre-ordered the deluxe edition or the grade A edition, then you got it on Tuesday. But for everyone who didn't, who's kind of new to the game, didn't want to pre-order because they didn't know what they were getting into, the game officially came out on Friday, yesterday, October 16th. So today's video, we're gonna kind of go into EASHL a little bit. EA Sports Hockey League or World of Chell, depending on what you know it as. And I'm gonna kind of do this right off the beginning. I've been playing a little EASHL here and there on Xbox and PlayStation. And I'm gonna give you guys my builds, my early builds that I'm using for each position. And for either sixes or threes. So I'm gonna kind of give you guys a insight in on what I like to use, how I like to play. And I've had people who've used my builds in the past, have liked them. So I figured I'd give all this information to you guys at the beginning of the year so you guys can try it out and let me know how you feel about these builds. But before we get over there, make sure you guys hit that sub button, give it a thumbs up, and turn that bell on so you get notifications every time we drop a new video. We got a couple fun series that I'm going to be putting out for you, some more EASHL, HUT, you name it, in NHL 21. We're going to have some sort of video out there for you. So again, make sure you hit that sub button, give me a thumbs up, and turn that bell on so you guys know when we drop a new video. If you want to see me play some EASHL, want to see me play some HUT, you want to see me play NHL 21 at all, make sure you click the link in the description and make sure you go follow me over on Twitch, twitch.tv, BigCountry7914. Also, follow me on Twitter and Instagram, both BigCountry7914. And if you're looking to get into EASHL and you want to find some people to play with, join the Shoot Score Happy Discord. The links are going to be in the descriptions for all of these. Make sure you click them all and come be a part of our community. To touch on the Discord a little bit, we got a lot of people in there that like to share their HUT clips, cards they pull, EASHL clips, some of the fun goals, or if you're just looking for people to play, just post in the chat, be like, hey, you know, anybody need one? And I'm sure somebody would be like, yeah, come play with us. Everyone is very friendly. We are trying to get competitive, but we're not over competitive that we're gonna tear a newbie apart. We want everyone to enjoy this game and even teach you along the way. So if that's something you're looking for, join the Shoot Score Happy Community Discord. Again, link in the description. But now let's get into these builds. I'll show you my builds, show you what my process, and let's do it. I don't know what else to say, so here they are. So you're gonna click on World of Chell. Loading screens, NHL 21. Still kind of slow. Thought that'd be a little quicker, but it is what it is. This is new season's player ranks that they're doing. They got ones, NHL 3's eliminated, and EASHL, you get bronze, silver, yeah. Work your way up. This is kind of a new rating system that they have for clubs this year. So we can skip that. Then they're gonna show you your challenges. You got your different modes, pro-am, ones, threes, drop, and then drop-ins. And you, as you complete challenges, as you can see in the drop-ins, I've completed six of the challenges. That's why it's grayed out. But if I completed 6 out of 9, I get that Oktoberfest home jersey. And then if I complete all 15 of them, then I get everything that's on the board there. So once you get past that challenge, this is the menu you're gonna come to. It's just the different game modes, pro-am, multiplayer, clubs, customized, rewards, stats, settings. Rewards, that's where you're gonna find your hockey bags to get like your items like you got here. Like you see, I got a white cap on, a Chell sweatshirt, the base pants that they give you, because I don't think I unlocked any pants yet, and then skates. I always rock pink laces, which I've always done. I've done it since you've been able to change the color of your laces. But where you're going to want to go is you're going to want to go to Customize. And then after you go to Customize, you're going to want to go to Edit Loadouts. And if you're a beginner to this, you're only going to have one loadout. Right now, I got two unlocked. But as of right now, you only got one loadout. And that's where we're going to start. So let's clear everything here so I can show you guys from the beginning of what we're going to do. And we'll reset. So we're going to reset that. What I always go to is I always go to power forward. Power forward is my winger position at the beginning of the game. The bigger builds, it allows you not to be knocked off the puck as much. I know a lot of people like to use the sniper or playmaker. They're like a little more faster, but I feel like the power forward, you're able to control the puck a little bit better than those smaller builds. This is just a preference for me. I'm giving you guys all my preference. I'm showing you guys like what I go through, what I like to use, my go-to. I've been using power forward since NHL 08 when they introduced World of Chell, and you were able to make your own builds, and I've been using it all the way through. Even when we got to NHL 15 and they gave you your pre-built builds, you were only able to choose like playmaker, power forward, and sniper, and two-way. I think you were only able to use like three or four builds. And then when they finally started gradually getting back into more builds, like we're seeing here, you got power forward, playmaker, two-way forward, enforces defenseman, puck moving defenseman, offensive defenseman, two-way defenseman, defensive defenseman, enforcer, grinder, dangler, sniper, back to power forward. I've always have come back to power forward, and I've always found, for me, is where I find the most success. So that's why I'm going to show you guys my builds. If you want to use my builds, more than happy to. I'm more than happy to continue giving you the upgrades throughout the year. Like again, make sure you go over and follow my Twitch. I stream Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, and every other Saturday. So you make sure you come into the stream and just ask me about the builds. Ask me if there's any updates. But I'm gonna give you guys the beginner, and then as you can see at the top right corner, I'm at level 5, so I'm gonna kind of give you my first attributes that I've added. So power forward beginning, here it is. So power forward, you want to save it. 6'4 is the height I use. The pounds, so if you drop down pounds, you're gonna lose it in body checking, balance, durability, and fighting. And then if you keep going down, you gain 1 in speed. If you go down to 214, you gain 1 attribute in speed, acceleration, agility, and endurance. I think as low as you can go is 210. So where you're losing in balance, strength, durability, you are gaining in speed, acceleration, and agility. But the reason why I choose this build is for that balance, strength, and durability. So instead of losing those overalls, I'll keep mine at 220. I don't lose, I don't gain anything. Like if you went up in weight, you can get a little more strength, but you lose your speed, your acceleration, and agility. Kind of the vice versa. But so I'll leave it right at the 220 mark. Good balance, right in the middle. I shoot left. That's just my preference. If you shoot righty, make sure you choose righty right here. But I'm a lefty, so I choose lefty. So this is kind of my base start. This is what I start off. This is my powerful build right off the beginning. I use this for my right wingers, and I use this for my left winger. If I'm going to be a center, because if you're playing center, you got to make up more space. I will go with a two-way forward here. So, again, with the two-way, I'll go up to about 6'2". So I'll go up to 6'2". I'm gaining that bounce and that durability, a little bit more body checking. Yes, I'm losing a little bit of speed and acceleration and agility, but if you notice, the speed, acceleration, agility is still a little bit higher than what the power forward would be. But now if you drop down the weight, you just got that back. And now you're pretty much back to even where you were. You lost a little bit of strength. I mean, you could drop down to 185. I don't like being that light in weight because I feel like I got knocked off the puck too easily. So I'll go 194 is about as low as I will go. I lose a little one in strength, but that's all right. Again, shoots left. So this is my center build, and this is actually also my winger build in threes. So two-way forward, center for sixes, center for threes, and also winger for threes. I'll leave in the description each build and where I would use them. I'll even do a recap at the end of this video to kind of give you guys an idea. So power forward and two-way are my two main forward builds. Now let's go to defense. So if I'm doing sixes D, either playing right D or left D on sixes, I go two-way defenseman. I leave him at 6'2". And I'll leave it at 205. So for sixes defense, I use the two-way defenseman, 6'2", 205. I don't touch anything on here. I don't feel like if you go up or down in weight, up and down in height, it really is gonna affect this build at all. So I just kind of leave it where it's at. And then our final build that we use is a puck moving defenseman for threes. The only time I use this is for threes on defense. Only time I'll use this build. We'll go up to 6'2". And we drop it down to 185. I know I described earlier that I don't like to drop the weight down too much, but when you're playing threes, it's much more open ice and you're not gonna be getting hit as much. You're gonna kinda want the little bit of speed there. So the puck moving defenseman is strictly threes. So we're gonna start with the puck moving defenseman, and I'll give you kind of the traits that I'll put in. Unfortunately, you don't really unlock a lot of traits at the beginning. So for puck moving, we'll definitely use precision passing because you're gonna want the passing there. And then also you're gonna want to use the bouncer too, which yes, it ups your fighting skill, but it also ups your acceleration and your body checking. So let's add that there. And then a specialty trait, quick defensive stick. I always like the quick defensive stick because I use my poke check a lot. That's how I play my defense. I use it to just kind of get it in lanes to force the opponent to do something that they're uncomfortable doing. You can choose the hot saucer. I like the quick defensive stick. And also remember that this is just for up to level 5. You're gonna unlock more traits as you go. So, and then if you really want to go in justice, if you kind of see things have kind of got changed because of the different traits you put on, if you wanted to go in and maybe up the weight a little bit, you get a little more durability if you even just go up 1 pound. And the strength goes up, durability goes up. Your speed might drop one, but you still get the acceleration and agility. So that's up to you. I'm gonna leave it at 185. So that's what I got for my puck moving defenseman. Now let's go back to the two-way forward. Also again, level 5. And you're not gonna really have a lot of traits. So same thing, bouncer, Do the precision passing again, and then same thing, quick defensive stick. And you're pretty much, those are the traits that I think are the best when you're kind of starting out. I'm gonna hop over, it's gonna be the same exact traits for the power forward and the two-way defenseman. So now let me show you guys a higher level and kind of the difference of traits that you can use as you continue to level up your player. All right, so now I'm gonna kind of show you my where my traits are now that I am at a level 11. Kind of show you, continue with the power forward, 6'4", 210. I dropped the weight down a little bit. Now that I got different type of traits I could add on. So we still got the bouncer on, add the strongman, which is gonna give you the strength, durability, fighting. You kind of, if you see here, you kind of got all the green on the right side. You lose a little bit of agility, a little bit of bounce, but you're kind of gaining on everything else. Then you're the stretch passer. That's kind of what I'm running at the power forward position. We'll look at the puck moving to defenseman. Now that it is a level 11, I got the bouncer again, interceptor, and then backskating. Definitely want the backskating on if you're going to be a defenseman. It allows you to skate backwards faster. Kind of makes sense. Because you really don't want to be getting beat when you got a guy coming in on you one-on-one quick. If you get beat on the outside, you're kind of gonna be up creek without a paddle. So and then we'll take a look at two-way defenseman and two-way forward. We'll start with the two-way forward. We'll add the traits on. A good thing too is if you have traits and you got them unlocked, so this is what I got unlocked so far. See, I like the strongman because it adds the strength and durability. I feel like puck possession is going to be key in this game. Again, the bouncer gives you a little bit of acceleration, a little bit of body checking. And then my specialty trait we'll go from the quick defensive stick to the stretch passer. Increase to passing power and accuracy for stretch passes. So now you kind of look at it, you see what has been bumped up, what's been bumped down. You kind of change your height if you really want. Like I said, I like to go to 6'2 and kind of drop the weight a little bit. Probably about like 194. Looks like a good balance point. 194 looks like a good balance point. You know, you get the acceleration still, but you still got the endurance, your strength, durability. It's kind of what we're looking for. And then we'll take a look at two-way defenseman. Again, put your traits on. I'll use the same ones. Bouncer, strongman, and then on defense, backskating. So now that you just see it right off the bat, acceleration went up, strength, durability, body checking. Defensive awareness went down a little bit, hand, eye, and puck control. But I mostly look at the athleticism part of it. I feel like the offensive defensive part is going to be more based on how you play. Athleticism is going to be more on based by the game. So that's how I kind of look at that. I'll keep it at 6'2". Probably drop the weight a little bit. Actually, not even going to touch the weight. So we're going to leave it like that. That's our two-way defenseman build. So these are the builds that I've been running for years now. Like I mentioned earlier in the video, I've been playing EASHL since NHL 08. Always use power forward. I've been messing around with the two ways, but I've always go back to the power forward, especially at the beginning of the game, to kind of really get a feel of the athleticism side of the game. That's why I kind of really focus on the athleticism part of the player builds. So let me know if you like them. Let me know if you use them. Let me know how you feel about them. And if you do use them and you tweak a trait here or there, or the weight or height, comment below. Let me know, because I would like to try it out. I'm always willing to try different things out. Like I said, this is what works for me right now. Give it another month into this game. I unlock different types of traits. I mean, it seems like that they've added new traits to this game that haven't been in the game before. So I might be going down a different alley. But until then, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Remember, I do stream over on Twitch every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, and every other Saturday. You can also find me on Twitter and Instagram, BigCountry7914. And make sure you join the Shoot Score Happy Community Discord. And if you guys are coming and watching this video right after I just finished a 24-hour stream, type 24 in the chat, in the comment section. I would love to know if you guys stuck through this video to the end and want to know if you came over from my 24-hour stream. Just type 24 in the comment section. Give it a thumbs up. Make sure you hit that sub button, and we'll see you next time. Have a good one.